Hey, many fish. It's the 4th of January, 2018, and we got a blizzard. We got a bomb cyclone right on top of us right now. But I can still talk to you. And I was reading this particular article, and man, I got down here. What is a bomb cyclone? And I'm reading it, and I see 24 millibars in 24 hours, and like right instantly, it was like 24 came right into my thinking about Ron Wyatt and the 24 chromosomes in the blood of Christ he found. And yes, I do believe he found that. In fact, I know he did. This is just my personal understanding of it. And so it brings that to memory, and then it caused me to go in, start investigating some things. I don't know why, it just led me back into this. With the X chromosome and the Y chromosome and the 46 and 23 and 69 and all these things that could confuse the heck out of all of us. But what it really boils down to is the X chromosome is the chromosome that the woman carries, okay? It's found in both males and females, but it's the primary one that carries the female genome, or whatever it is you'd call it. I'm not a biologist, but that's what it is. And it's amazing if you read this. I mean, granted, it's Wikipedia, okay? So they're not telling us a whole bunch of stuff. But this is really wild. It says down here that the X chromosome in humans spans more than 153 million base pairs. 153, which are the building material of the DNA. And that the woman's genealogy, the way that the female chromosome, the mother chromosome, is passed on generationally, is done in a Fibonacci sequence, which, if you don't know what that is, fascinating. In other words, like the two, the birth mother and then the child, okay? The father donates the other X from his mother into that child, as well as the Y chromosome, which his X and Y determine the sex. The blood, the chromosome in Jesus' blood was a Y, a male. So you have the two, which two and one are three. And this is how the female mother genealogy progresses. Exactly like this. Three and five are eight. Eight and five are 13. 13 and eight, 21. You see what I'm saying? And it goes on into infinity, and it forms what's known as the golden spiral, the Fibonacci sequence. It's amazing. And the Y chromosome, the one that was found in the blood of Jesus, on top of the 23 from the mother. He only got the physical, like hair color, eyes, you know, facial features, stuff like that, he got from his mother. But his manhood, he got from one Y chromosome to make the 24. And they say it was not human. Okay, now that aside, you use your own discretion on that. But the Y chromosome is absolutely fascinating too. And just a side note, they try and tell you here that before there was a before humans, okay? They get into evolution here. And it's disgusting, quite frankly, and it makes zero sense. So now I'm heavy into the whole seed. I want to know what the seed. So I just Bible search the seed, and there's a lot. But what I found super interesting here is that in the Hebrew, throughout the Old Testament, when the seed, in other words, the posterity, seed, figuratively fruit, plant, sowing time, posterity, child, fruitful seed, H2233. Now, isn't that just a coinky dink? And we go into the Greek, into the New Testament, and we can pick pretty much any one of these. There's a lot, I could tell you that. We come up with 4690. So you got 2233. Okay, I gotta give you like a clean slate to put this stuff on, because If I don't, you won't be able to see it. So we got the 2233 in the Hebrew, meaning posterity. And we have the 494690, meaning including the male sperm. That's what that word means. 4690. 4690 and 2233. Combine those two together. This is pretty amazing, actually. I mean, it really is. If you take those two, 2233, add the 4690, you get 6923. Now, I'll tell you what this tells me. The 69, I think I already went through that, but if I didn't, 69 is there's no biblical relevance to it. It's a dark Illuminati, you know, occult number. Okay, basically it means a supernatural world leader. It literally means, you know, the Antichrist. They're numeric. It's crazy. I will link this, but biblically it means nothing. It's simply an occultic number. You know, they use the number 23 occultically too, but I'm not going to go there, okay? I'm going to link this stuff, and you guys really have to use your own discretion on all this. You really do. But just the fact that those two numbers add up to 6923 is pretty wild. You got to admit. I mean, like, maybe it was done on purpose. But what was really fascinating as well as Ron Wyatt clearly states multiple times that the day that he was brought and led into that chamber where the Ark of the Covenant was, where he retrieved the blood, was on January 6th, 1982. That was the date. So I got to go back to January 6th, 1982, and I went to a couple of different places. First, I went here. 1219. What is 1219? That's when they burnt the incense for the first time in 2,000 years, people. Okay? It was also the same day that they opened and dedicated this synagogue in the Western Wall with this crazy globe ark that took 12 years to build. And if you don't think that there are not doors and chambers to go all over Jerusalem out of this area, you're dreaming, because there is nothing but tunnels running everywhere. So my question is are they trying to get over to where, you know, Jeremiah's grotto, you know, Golgotha, where he says the ark is? I don't know. I'm just throwing this stuff out there because it's crazy. But from that day that he discovered the ark until that giant ceremony they had there, that was a big deal on the 19th. I'm sorry, it was. 13,131 days? Seriously? I mean, and you can do a whole bunch of things with these numbers. You really can. I'm not going to get into the numbers because it's just, you know, one of those things. You have to use discretion, discernment, pray on it to have an understanding of what I'm trying to tell you. All I'm really trying to tell you is that you and me and everybody else are just, when those two first cells, when that first cell splits into the first two cells, at that instant, we are all endowed with a good side and a bad side. And the soul gets stuck in the middle in the flesh. The flesh is the deception. The flesh is the sin, because it is. Again, I'm not a theologian. I'm not a biologist, but I understand what all this means. And this stuff is hardcore, for real. Remember how the woman genealogy moves like the Fibonacci sequence? You see that there? It all fits together, and this all goes back. This knowledge goes back way beyond Babylon, all of it. It goes way, way back. And to this very day, it's used in virtually everything. And it's very clear that that is what has been hidden from us for all these years. That all you need do is turn from the wicked, from that bad side, that yang of the yin-yang, the bad 23, I don't know, whatever you want to call it. But you got to turn from it and seek the soul part, okay? There's a soul in you. This little graphic here does it pretty good. Okay? We all know that, you know, we get spiritual, but you got to dig down into your soul. That's where Jesus is, and that's who you need, because what's coming ain't going to wait. Okay? So 13,131 days till that ritual from the day of the discovery of the blood. Okay? Think about that. From that day to the first day of the new Hebrew year, March 17th, is 88 days. That is significant. 2,112 hours. You can do all the number stuff yourself, but believe me when I tell you that's significant. The bottom line is it's all about the blood, the seed. I mean, that's all you need to do is understand that there are two entities in you battling constantly. That's why we just can't help but that little lie comes out. We can't help but give the finger to the guy that cut me off. We can't help but want to strangle the guy that can't talk English on the phone. We can't help it because it's in us. But we have to turn from that. Once you do, once you realize the awesomeness that created this entirety, then you flip the switch. You come to know Jesus. But you got to seek him. You got to seek him. Call on him by name. Show me the truth of who you are, Jesus. He'll show you. But yeah, I had to share that stuff with you. That's just crazy. 6923. Really? This is telling me the separation, folks, that the 69 are going to stay behind with the rest of these Illuminati monsters, basically. And the 23 who have flipped the switch are going home. It's the best way I know how to describe it. So I sincerely hope some of this makes sense to some of you, if not most of you, if not all of you. Seek Jesus, y'all. Please, you'd be amazed at the things he shows you and the peace that you have. So, seek him. Peace and grace to you. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,